Ranos here, and welcome to the episode of Space Engineers. Now to start off, I'd like to show you this armor. And a lot of you may recognize it from somewhere. Well, maybe not the jetpack. It's the Halo armor that Master Chief uses. Which the mod is still in beta, I think. Anyway, the mod is having some trouble with animations. He's gotten working, they're fine. But a few of the changes means he has to redo a bunch of all the animations. Like the whole jetpack thing. A lot of the animation has to be redone. And he's not very good at animating, as he's stated on the page. So I was wondering if there's any animators out there willing to help him. There'll be a link for this mod in the description below. So, if you're an animator, go there and see if you can help him out. Because I think this will be a really good mod, especially for the Halo fans. And this can actually be used in, like, Team Deathmatch games. That'd be fun. Anyhoodle, now to this mod review. I'll be reviewing two different Shipyard welders. One is much older than the other, and I've used it a lot. I've got it on the ship repair bay. I've also used it on Turtle, which is a ship I haven't even shown you yet. Well, anyway, we've got this red ship here, which is severely damaged. I'll take a little tour. And see, it's broken. Lots of it broken. Yeah, I went a bit crazy with a missile launcher and started smashing everything. I broke it, lad. Wee dampeners are absolutely useless. Yeah, I did a lot of damage. Anyway, we're going to be going into the first welder, which is the ones I've been using for a long time. You see, set it all up. Those are three different types. We have the corner ones. We have the struts, which is what I use mostly. So I think they're just the most efficient one for space. And then we've got the flat panel ones, which help make up the bulk of this chamber. Anyway, we've got two of these ready since there are two different types. And I'll be hopping in. Well, I'm going to get this ship into position and then I'll be right back. And I'm back, and I noticed I made a slight miscalculation on the width this thing needed to be. Yeah, it was too narrow. Whoopsie. Alright, how about we turn on the first ones? It will be a bit lag, because there's a lot of them. As you see, it's now fixing up the entire ship. All I gotta do is then hop off of the seat I'm on up here. Am I? And fly over! I'm gonna do this in the first person. Now I've gotta fly down here. Just try not to be in here when it's active in survival mode. Yeah, you tend to die. Not the most pleasant of experiences. I gotta move in. And yes, we do generate lots of lag, which is annoying. Anyway, let's go back to this one. Because all we need to do is fix up the rear end of the ship now. If you make it longer than this, then you can just do it in one go. I didn't quite make it as long. You see, it's now fixing all the damages, getting all the dents out, putting the missing blocks back on. And there you have it. It's fully repaired the entire ship. Let's go and turn off the welder and then get everything ready for showing the next one. Alright, I'll be right back. And we're back. Since the red ship was actually too large for these welders and grinders, I had to switch to a different ship. So I picked up Doberman. No, Great Dane. Yeah, this was called Great Dane. And you see, it's quite beaten up. Quite a few hulls and the cockpit is incredibly messy. Don't ask about the windows. Something changed in the mod which caused them to do that. Oh well. Right, inside hasn't suffered too much damage, but it is noticeable. Ooh, it's dark. Oh, it needs a new door. Right, the amount of damage this caused should be easily fixed by these welders, which we'll see by turning them on. Lag! Here we go. Oh no, it's not even turned on yet. Ooh, why is it so on? Oh, there we go. Yep, turns all red when it's turning on. Okay, that one's off. That one hasn't even been built yet. Wait, why isn't it welding? Too high up. Maybe. And here we go. Let's fly over and move it around. Because it should be in range. Not sure why it isn't. Oh, now it's doing all the fixing. Just one. This was the best setup that the mod makers suggested. Not too sure. It's not even doing all that much. I got a turret to turn off. Just type in turret. Ooh, lag. That's really making it difficult to do anything. Oh my, I wonder what's going to be typed. Ooh, no. Well, I had a bit of a lag issue there. Kind of annoying. And I'm not quite sure why those welders weren't fixing it. It's kind of strange. That's why the range was much greater than that. Oh well, never mind. Anyway, the next thing we're going to do is go into the grinders. I see they're already active. Well, the first thing that's going to go is the pilot seed. Unless they move quick enough. Because this thing's actually much more effective at breaking things down, doing its job. Let's just go for midsection. Which means. Yeah! Oh my. That's probably much tail in that as well. And now, if we go through to the rest of the ship, leaving all doors open. Why do the doors still closed? That's weird. As you can hear, the grinders are breaking down the ship. And you can see parts being broken down. Let's open the door. Go outside. Wait, isn't maybe something there? Oh well. Anyway. Open number one. Whee! Just don't fly this close when you're in survival mode. Because it will kill you. That, ooh, it's mainly got the butt. Wait, why is the... Well, that's one thing I forgot to do. I left the blueprint on! Oops. That's gonna cause some lag issues. So, how about we fix that? And turn it off. That will clean up the lag a little. You may. As you can see, it breaks down. It's not the fastest thing around. You'll probably use the vanilla grinders to do something a bit faster, like with the grinders grid that I usually make in survival mode. It's normally like a 25 by 25 grid of grinders, without any gaps between them. They can grind things down pretty quickly. But these seem to be doing an alright job. Bring down all the heavy armor. Wow. It is breaking down quickly, isn't it? I wonder what the insides look like. Because this will actually take a very long time. Yeah. See, all the grinders look interesting. And with both the welders and grinders of, well, this type, there's conveyor ports on both sides there. And also, at it, right? There's another one there. Not only that, with this type, there's an extended version. The Shipyard mod has extended versions of both Grinder and Welder, which have much greater range. But I don't have any of them currently equipped. Although I think the Welders would have been helpful over that one. Might actually help fix this bugger up from up close. And this is gonna take a while. So yeah, I'll just leave that to it. I did have all the welders set up to show you their build range, knows how far they can reach, using a blueprint of that. However, I built the thing ridiculously too large, and it causes a great deal of lag, which prevents me from doing that. It's really annoying. Seriously, I've tried for over 4 hours to get the blueprint just to show up. It wouldn't work. Oh, it's annoying. Anyway, these are the welders. Well, that's the grinders, the welders, and even more welders. And that's all that comes with both mods. Not much, but they're both useful. Especially for making various things, and this is now a big hole. Well, anywho, I hope you've all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye. Although I'm going to show you a clip of me nuking that thing! Boom. Oh, those were laggy. Nyeh. That's a pain. Oh, well. Well, as you can see, nukes are deadly. My. Very deadly indeed. Wow, a lot more damage than I thought it would. A lot more damage. As you can see, launch a nuke at something, it won't survive! Fun! Alright, I'm gonna keep nuking this thing. Bye!